Greetings, travelers. Welcome to day three of Seatstory Cup number three. We are here to bring you some amazing action from Group D. And this is going to be the second match inside Group D. We see the previous match. Oskaka beat Firebat, right? 3-1. And now we're going to see the second match in this group to determine who is going to face Oskaka in the winner's finals. Is it going to be Maverick or is it going to be Hyped? So that match will be right now. So what do you think, Gara? Tell us a little bit more about those players.
The Maverick army is already here, raiding the chat, and I'm actually very excited to see Maverick. I've never seen Maverick play in... I've never watched him actually play, even though I heard about him a lot and saw him in online cups and everything. But I know Hyped, obviously, is from my team. I'm rooting for him. Everyone dropped out from Tempo Storm except him, so... I'm still waiting for him to win like a big tournament. Like, he's a very good player, but he never really won something like a DreamHack or a big event like this. So I'm obviously rooting for him and hoping him to perform really well today.
Yeah, Hyped obviously waiting for his chance to finally make a breakthrough performance, hopefully here at Seatstory Cup 3. However, Maverick is going to be a really big roadblock in his way. Maverick, one of those underrated players who obviously don't get much exposure because he's, for example, not streaming as much and is kind of in a secluded French Hearthstone community. But we've seen glimpses of Maverick's playstyle already on this stream. When, for example, he played against Life Coach, which was one of the best series in this whole tournament, for example, and Maverick... in decisive fashion, actually, won his group, and Hyped barely came through his group. So we'll see if Hyped can actually match up to Maverick here. But he definitely is a player of a caliber that can definitely do it.
I've heard about the series. It was very great, very close, and the way how Life Coach lost was sad for him. But Life Coach is a very, very strong player, and to put up a fight against him already means. Or shows how good Maverick is as a player, so I wouldn't be surprised if he ends up winning.
Yeah, definitely. Life Coach, probably regarded as the best player right now in the world, I would say, by many people. And Maverick putting Life Coach to his limit, making Life Coach actually get rope scoped, or like I like to call it. Anyway, so Maverick right now in a really good position to just. He just wants to expand the momentum that he's built up to this point already. Maverick, of course, as I said before, didn't have much didn't have much exposure before that, but he has performed well in several tournaments already. Yeah. He won the Gamers Origin tournament in France, where several pros were already there, and he actually won that one. It was a 400-person tournament. And also he was at DreamHack Winter as well, where he had a pretty good performance. Came slightly short of actually getting into the top 8, but he was almost there.
Yeah, he's definitely no name. He's probably, obviously one of the best French players out there. But he's slightly less known than the other players from France, Best Marmotte or...
Yeah, he's actually from Belgium, but we. This is always what the casters get mixed up.
But he speaks French, right?
Yeah, speaks French, I would say. I guess he's from the French part of Belgium.
Yeah.
Yeah. But he's from the French community. He's from Belgium, but he is from the French community. And I think we're going to jump right into the game. We're going to see it from the Mavericks' point of view. And Hyped will be on top. So it's going to be Maverick on Warrior and Hyped on Hunter. And we see pretty standard decklist, I would say, right? Maverick with the Control Warrior and Hyped with... is it Face Hunter?
It is Midrange Hunter.
It is Midrange Hunter, actually. Okay.
It's an interesting list. I've seen the list, so I'm not going to spoil anything yet. It's just two or three new cards. Not really new cards, but not from the standard list.
Have we seen Hyped play this Hunter deck in the tournament yet?
I don't think so. I think it was banned every time.
Oh, okay.
It's AI. He said it earlier that it was banned every time.
Yeah, so definitely a lot of, hopefully a lot of surprises awaiting us there.
So this is usually a matchup you want to have. Because I feel Midrange Hunter is kind of weak right now, right? You would agree. Because people would play it if it would be good. and like the few matchups where it's supposed to be good, it would be like Warrior.
Yeah, definitely. And Hype definitely making good read here. Maybe he was even expecting Maverick to open up with Warrior. Maverick has done that before, right? I think in the previous match that he played, Maverick also led with the Warrior. So Hype hopefully capitalizing on that with this mid-range Hunter. And this is right here, this one. This is the card that I was really surprised to see when I first saw it. Four Reaper, 4,000. So Maverick probably the only guy who actually brought this card.
100%, oh my god.
Like, I've never seen this card in competitive play, and I'm really excited to see it here.
So is he not playing any VGH targets in his Warrior?
That could definitely be true.
Like, I haven't seen this, like, and I'm like super surprised, like, what the hell is that? Like, even just that idea, that's so, I find that very cool, like, when you watch the Chinese scene, or like the French scene, how it evolves different. Like, yes, they're copying like a lot of decks between each other, but they still have like their own styles.
Yeah, with the dominant presence of Dr. Boom, definitely everyone is running Big Game Hunter nowadays, so it is actually viable to just not play any Big Game Hunter targets in your decks.
And Warrior is like a class that could actually play for replaying, like realistically, not just as a fun card.
Yeah, anything. For sure. We've seen it in the past, and maybe Maverick does it here too. I haven't checked out his decks as much as I probably should have, but this might definitely be a strong choice here. Obviously, I think he's going to play the Grommash still, which is a Big Game Hunter target, right? Yeah. Like, this is pretty much an auto-include in every Control Warrior. So now what, as we can see, like, the start from I keep wanting to say Gaara because I see Gaara on the screen. Hype is actually playing on your account.
Getting Misha is definitely what you wanted from the Animal Companion. It's like the best. Like, as a mid-range hunter.
Yeah, definitely. But Maverick already has the Execute ready to go along with the Taskmaster to enable it.
Yeah, now the Huntmaster will be...
Yeah, what Hype definitely needs are going to be those late-game minions that are hard to deal with sometimes for the Warrior, like Seven of Hymen, like Dr. Boom.
He just saw the Taskmaster, so he will probably just kill the Armorsmith and use Quickshot for the Taskmaster. Because it's not that easy for a Warrior to deal one damage after he saw the Taskmaster already being played.
Yeah, many Warriors that I've seen actually have been cutting those kind of effects that deal one damage, even like Whirlwind or Abusive or Atypical. So, like, one of the only Whirlwind effects, for example, nowadays is Deathbite in those Warrior control decks. They are kind of a little bit more greedy here, especially in a tournament format. So, judging by those hands, who do you give the edge to right now? Is Maverick or Hyped?
I think Hyped has an edge because he has still the board and he has like the Mad Scientist. You always want to draw the Mad Scientist over the traps, right? And that's always a good sign.
Yeah, the Mad Scientist obviously, unlike in Face Hunter and Midrange Hunter, it's actually really good against the Warrior because it gives you the Freezing Trap, which is really strong against those late game minions that Warrior can put out.
He draws here the second Armorsmith, which will probably kill the knife juggler if everything goes right. It's kind of tough, like his hand kind of sucks. From the Warrior. Sort of. He doesn't have a weapon, so...
Yeah, and he's actually going to coin out the Shield Slam even. What target is he going to choose for that, though? Is it going to be the knife juggler or the Mad Scientist? I mean, the Mad Scientist is more logical, I guess, because the juggler threatens to die to... get killed by the Armorsmith anyway here with the one health.
That's a very big draw for next turn.
What was the trap that the scientist got? It's actually Freezing Trap, okay, as expected.
So you probably ignore the Mad Scientist, the Armorsmith.
Do you really though?
Like the knife juggler, I mean, he would have killed, I think he would have killed it if he could, like the knife juggler with another Taskmaster. And he played the Armorsmith to trade, like he shield slammed also the Mad Scientist over the knife juggler, so he wants to trade with the Armorsmith. And if he can't take with the Armorsmith, it kind of shows that you don't have an answer to the knife juggler.
But yeah, I guess so. It's kind of painful though to get to have the Warrior be able to remove to run one of his cheaper minions into the Freezing Trap. It's kind of painful for the Hunter. He wants to get those late game drops into those Freezing Traps.
But if you go face, like he can't use shield slam for the Hymen next turn. So that's like an argumentation for both. We'll see.
Oh, what do you think if the juggler actually hit the armorsmith? Do you think he would have attacked into it?
It's tough to say. Like, here value also like face damage a lot as a hunter. It doesn't matter what version you play. So at any point you get free damage. And if he, even if he has the weapon and then kills the knife juggler, it's like 6 damage he did with the knife juggler. Can be a big deal. I don't know if he would have killed it. Maybe he would.
I'm pretty sure we're going to see shield slam number 2 here on the Houndmaster.
But that's like awesome. Now he sees 2 shield slams being gone.
Yeah, and that opens the way for Savannah Hymen on turn 6 perfectly.
Yeah, 1 execute gone and 2 shield slams.
Yeah, now it's going to be like this is one of the minions that is hard to deal with in the first place for a warrior. And shield slam is one of those ways of actually effectively dealing with it for cheap. But now that those 2 shield slams are gone, Maverick's gonna have a hard time actually dealing with this high main.
And he has another knife juggler, so if he draws like another cheap minion, he can just Hunter's Mark and just snipe it down.
Oh yeah, that is gonna be a huge tempo swing right there. If the juggler's hit.
Yeah. Oh my god, that's like the perfect card. You can also hero power and you have the kill command, so he's just pushing for damage here.
So Shield Main says, I can take a hit, but will she actually get it?
Just one hit. She can take only one hit.
Oh! She doesn't get it?
Oh my god.
Oh my god!
That is so unlucky!
She says she can take a hit, but she actually did not get it. And now, he might actually... Hype Die might actually have to trade into this, otherwise... Otherwise the Shield Main just threatens to kill off the High Main.
Yeah, I think that's fine. And like he plays also a little bit around Brawl as well. Oh my god, that's a greedy list.
Yeah, the Isera are just way too clunky in this situation. This control warrior, as we can see, is pretty greedy. A lot of cards that have little to no impact when they actually enter the play, but when they stick around for one more turn, like this for Reaper and the Zera, then they generate so much value.
You took kill command this turn? Probably not, man.
Yeah, you don't really have to do it. You can just save it up. There's no way that your beasts are, or that all of your beasts are gonna die anyway.
I can take the hit. That's a good draw, like maybe it gives him another turn. He decides not to kill the high man.
Yeah, he really wants to use that shield main apparently to kill off the high main. But is that really worth it?
Oh, that's also really good.
Yeah, that was Troll Strider actually.
He's really strong because he's
threatening
can...
a lot of damage.
Yeah, I don't see the warrior coming back with any draw.
Yeah, it's just too much to handle, unless of course the warrior draws the brawl. But even then, the Death Rattle will still provide some minions.
Will he get some miraculous Boombot hits? If he attacks the Hunter Creeper and both bots kill like the 2 big minions, he can survive. Now, even then he's dead to kill command. So I guess this game is over. Even with the best Boombot hits.
Well, technically... Wait. Technically, I guess he can still survive. Right? Because with the armor up as well.
Yeah, he has 12 life, he has 6 plus 5, so it's like, yeah, he would survive from 1 HP. If he gets the best possible Boombot. No, right, he takes so 1 damage from the Hunter Creeper, so he's dead. Like, he would be down to 11, and he has 11 damage. What now? But he goes for the guaranteed death. I wonder if this play, there was like no way to survive.
Yeah, I don't know what Maverick was expecting from that, but I guess he was just sure that he lost there and took the concede, just pressed the concede button and is moving on to the next game. Hype taking the lead, 1-0.
So that was classic mid-range hunter versus warrior. Not so classic warrior deck though. with the... Too bad we didn't see the Four Reaper.
Yeah, I wanted to see it. It's kind of tough to play it in a situation like this. Against the mid-range hunter, you don't really have time to do that. You generally face down a lot of pressure through those mid-game minions, and you have to just play your best cards that are optimal for the situation. You don't really have time to skip a turn, basically, which is what those cards like Four Reaper and Isera do.
Yeah. Hype had really good draws. He had both Hunter's Marks for tempo. He drew the Mad Scientist over the traps. He had the high minion curve. He didn't draw the bow, even though like Merrick had the Harrison. It's like also kind of a big deal sometimes.
So now that Hyped Hunter is eliminated, he has one of two decks to choose, and he goes for the Rogue. He had the choice between Rogue and Druid, and he chose to go for the Rogue instead of the Druid, which would usually have a better matchup against Warrior, but I guess he expected Maverick to change his deck.
Yeah. I'm actually very excited to see Rogue. Not many people play Rogue in this tournament. Like, how many did actually bring Rogue? Somebody said it's very weak right now.
Yeah, Rogue has a little bit of a downswing in terms of popularity at the moment. Many players have been touting Rogue to be like one of the weaker classes at the moment, which is kind of weird considering that Emperor's Thorison seems to really fit the Rogue well in general, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And we see the Emperor's Thorison in Hyped's hand already, so we'll see how that comes into play. I think in a slower matchup like against the Control Warrior, it might come into play in a big way, actually.
I personally also expected more people to play Rogue just because of Emperor. Like, this is like the first deck that came to my mind to play Emperor in. It might even bring Auctioneer. I'm very surprised that the big Rogue players think that Rogue is still pretty weak.
Yeah, maybe people were expecting a lot of classes that generally perform well against Rogue being popular in this tournament, so that's why Rogue was kind of not popular at all.
Yeah, most people were afraid of Face Hunter, and I'm actually surprised how few people bring Face Hunter.
Yeah, I was really surprised about that as well.
Oh, he has like the coin sludge version to sludge, so that's like the dream.
Yeah, that's really annoying for the Rogue to deal with. Usually the Rogue can just kind of deal with easily with the sludge pressure by using Sap, but that's more of like a late game plan.
And he has the armor smith behind it. It's like, that's like the most disgusting board for a Rogue.
Yeah, the Warrior will definitely deal generate a lot of armor with that.
He would just... I mean, he has a couple options. He can Lord Tap or just Zap it. Like, usually sludge pressure is the target you Zap.
It kind of stinks, though, using Zap this early in the stage of the game. Usually just want to first establish your board properly with minions, and then once your opponent is on the defense from your board with taunters, then just generate a lot of tempo by using those Saps and push through with attacks. But right now, Hyped is not in this position, unfortunately for him.
That's a pretty nice clear. Here's the board. Still the Death Rattle minion up. But he still has to deal with those two sludge pilchers. Tarasen will be strong. We'll see.
Yeah, especially when the Rogue hands is pretty full after like a prep sprint. With this kind of hand though, it might be a little bit too few cards to actually generate like optimal advantage out of Thorison. Usually Rogue should be in a spot where he has a lot more cards to make more use out of Thorison.
Do you think this play is like a little bit too greedy to go for the Taskmaster Acolyte over the Sludge Pilcher?
I kind of agree here. You generally want to get rid of your expensive cards earlier to have more options in the following turns. Otherwise, you just clog up your hand too much with too many cards that cost too much. So I definitely would have played the Belcher there. But it seems like Maverick is just digging for some more options here. Question is, what does he even want to see here? I'm pretty sure the Belcher play was pretty fine.
Yeah. Like, he can't trade with the board effectively. I guess he wants, like... Maybe he's looking for the Brawl. Maybe he thinks he will really need the Brawl in this game. I don't know. Maybe looking for Shield Maidens.
Now, when you're in Hype's position, what do you even do with this kind of board? Do you maybe you just want to go face instead?
Yeah. Like trading with an acolyte that is buffed wheels with your shredder feels awkward.
I guess in order to protect your Emperor Thorsen properly, you want to get rid of those minions. Yeah. And now Thorsen is looking to generate a lot of value.
The egg is awesome.
Yeah, Maverick might actually be in a spot where he cannot deal with this Thorsen.
Yeah. He can't.
Unless he double shield slams it, I guess.
Oh my god, is he that desperate?
You know, keeping a Thorsen alive for one for more than one turn is
usually GG.
Really devastating.
But he saw the zap, right? So the Sylvanas is not that risky. Like if you saw one zap already?
Yeah, I guess considering that Hype's hand is not that large, Maverick might actually be a little bit safer against this Thorsen right now. Still, it's pretty annoying to leave it alive.
He will definitely not trade. He's going face and get the... But what do you do? Like, ignoring Sylvanas is usually also not good.
just imagine Maverick actually went for the Belcher. He would have had the perfect solution against the Thorsten with Taskmaster into Big Game Hunter.
Yeah. You really have to, now always to keep the Thorsten in mind as a play. Against every deck.
Yeah, nowadays definitely any deck that's not an aggro deck pretty much just runs Thorsten because it's just so damn good.
So he's going for the...
Oh, the Blade Fury being played for the ultimate combo into the big Edwin, generating a lot of pressure for Hyped.
Oh man, if he draws Brawl here, then he would have actually won because of the Acolyte play. Because he would just brawl the board and see what is left, and Hyped has nothing left.
Doesn't have it though. So what does Maverick do now? How does he deal with his board properly?
Oh,
he probably needs a really good RNG on this Sylvanas right now.
Yeah, you have to steal the 6-6 sort of, kill the 5-5. He still has a full board, but that's like what you really need.
Alright, what does he get? Gets the SI7.
One more to the right.
Yeah.
So, can you slam the Dr. GG now?
You could, but how much damage are you actually facing here? It's like 10 damage on the board already with the hero power, it's 11. So that is actually... Rogue might actually, with the Tinker's Sharpsword all, might threaten lethal. Tinker's Sharpsword all into something like an Eviscerate.
But I agree, but you have to do the winning play, and the winning play is definitely just play the biggest minion you can.
Yeah, of course. This is Maverick definitely in a kind of situation where he needs to do a play like this. And fortunately for him, it works out. Hype does not have anything to deal lethal here, but he has a lot of ways to actually expand the board advantage and also disrupt a lot of spells for Maverick with this low tap here.
Low tap is really good when you have the tempo already. It really depends on Hype's next draw. If it's like a sharp soil or something like that.
Already early on, we thought Maverick has this game in the bag, I think, but considering this Emperor Thorsten and Hype not and Maverick not being able to deal with it immediately, this actually swung around in Hype's favor more than we thought. And now Hype definitely in the driving seat here.
You think he's going for the Eviscerate? Low tap, Eviscerate face?
Well, that is certainly a possibility, but is it really necessary to do it?
The warrior has like a full hand. It's like he didn't get the sprint. Pretty sure he plays sprint.
It seems like Hype's going for the heal bot instead.
Okay.
A little bit more pressure on the board right now. Considering there wasn't a brawl for that many turns, you don't really need to play around the top deck brawl.
Yeah, he couldn't do it anyways because of low tap.
That's true. So
this is... He needs the best boom wards of his life.
Oh my god, that is actually quite alright.
He needs...
Yeah, he needs right? You can just use the shield slam now to finish this Edwin off.
Do you think it's important to play Sludge Belcher this turn to not die?
What now? Well, let's say he runs the Dr. Boom into the low tap, and then the shield slam on the Edwin.
He needs another good bomb.
Huh. But you of course always run the risk of killing the Nerubinek with the Boombot. And there it is!
Oh! Close one. Close one.
Almost, almost. Yeah, he's definitely gonna go for a shield slam on the Edwin, I think.
In this case, the one damage was the best outcome. On the egg when you already hit it. So he's not dead yet.
He needs to go for the shield slam right now to prevent a lot of damage from that Edwin would otherwise deal. And now we see though Eviscerate plus
one of
heal. Oh my god, one damage of lethal. Hyped.
And he can't backstab the egg because of the bomb.
Yeah. Wow, this is really rough for Hyped here. Especially considering that Alexstrasza is threatening to just heal Maverick up to 15 again.
Which is crazy, he's evil.
Oh, he's actually gonna eviscerate the Dr. Boom here. I guess it's fine to do that.
Yeah, he's playing around Alexstrasza.
There's pretty much no difference between putting the warrior to 1 or to 5 in this situation.
Yeah. You can see that he played like a lot of rogue games. Like, maybe some people would tend to just, you know, Yulo face, bring him down to 1.
So now the question is, will we actually see the Alexstrasza, or does Maverick choose to play something else? There's obviously the option of just going for a Sludge Belcher into Armor Up Shield Slam, for example, on the Healbot.
Yeah, that's fine too. But the Alexstrasza will definitely kill the 3-5 then.
Yeah.
And then you have the 2 Sludge Belchers next turn.
Right now Maverick is definitely on the verge of stabilizing this game in his favor. However, all it takes pretty much is Hyped to draw one of his sprints.
Yeah. And then suddenly it looks very bad for the warrior again.
Okay, that's not a sprint. So Maverick still in a safe position.
So now that he saw the defensive Alexstrasza, he might as well like take 8 face damage if he wants to clear the Alexstrasza. Like he's not scared of dying at least anytime soon.
Yeah, he can just ignore his Alexstrasza. And it's what he has to do pretty much.
Yeah. Do backstab it.
It's not necessary, considering that backstab also is a combo enabler for Tinker's Sharp Sword, for example.
Yeah. Yeah, you always usually keep one card in hand. You never know what you draw. But it gives 1/1/1. If he trades with Alexstrasza, he can't backstab it. It's like many different scenarios. Man. He really played a double Sludge Belcher. That looks pretty safe.
Yeah, that looks pretty safe. Also considering that one sap is gone already, it is very unlikely that Hyped will actually draw into the second one. Considering that he has 17 cards in his deck.
Looks like he's going for at least one. I mean, even just like armoring up Shield Slam, the 3-2 and one Sludge Belcher.
Yeah, obviously, awesome. Like, obviously, double Sludge Belcher would leave him open to something like Azure Drake into Eviscerate. But how do you really want to play against that? Play around that?
Yeah, but if he plays just one, is he dead to? Yeah, he's dead to Zap. It's just taking like a different risk.
Yeah, I guess
now,
so.
But now he's dead to one card. Azure Drake plus Eviscerate are 2 cards. Is he dead though? No, he's not dead though. No, he's not dead to Zap. It's not enough damage.
Oh, Dr. Boom, definitely one of those high impact cards that Hype needed to hopefully close out the game. But will it actually be enough? We see a Big Game Hunter being able to deal with that Dr. Boom immediately. Yeah.
It really looks like he's gonna stabilize. He needs some big bombs. Is he gonna attack with one or with... He just goes with both. He doesn't know the opponent has another Sludge Belcher, so he's investing a lot to kill the one. Oh. That cut is too slow. You have to go, yeah. Sludge Belcher BGH armor up is pretty obvious.
Yeah. This will most certainly put Maverick out of range of anything that Gara can draw, that Hype can draw right now.
Gara can't draw anything here, man, except...
Oh, the preparation! Not what Hype needed. That's for sure.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah, that is just sometimes what happens when you play Rogue. It's a really powerful deck in general and can do a lot of unfair things. But when you don't get the cards that you need, like Sprint, in order to stay ahead in card advantage, you just have sometimes pretty bad draws like that. And that's just how it goes. Maverick tying up the series 1-1.
I'm pretty sure his heart was pumping in this one. Like, it was so close. He was so close to death. Like, one damage of lethal.
Yeah. It was. I mean, Maverick didn't see the one damage of lethal, but still.
He saw the full board and that. Yeah.
Hype definitely disappointed at that. He was so close to actually taking a huge lead here in this series. And. Oh man, now Maverick tying up the series once more. We will see actually how this series evolves.
So there's Rogue and Druid left on Maverick's side and Mage and Rogue on Hyped side. Still gonna see some skilled matchups, like the Rogue Mirror for example. Do you think it's like very RNG-ish or one of the more skilled matchups? Like the most skilled mirrors compared to a Druid mirror, for example, the Rogue mirror.
Yeah, I'm like, but I think we have to like reconnect, right?
What
we don't see, hyped cards. But what do you think? I actually think that in general, Hype should be favored, like based on bias, pretty much. Hype, known for his rogue gameplay.
He should be favored in the mirror. That's a good one.
Yeah, like Hype has played a lot of rogue games, right? Yeah, you can confirm that.
Yeah.
And based on this fact, I would actually give the edge to Hype in this scenario.
Yeah, he definitely knows like what to mulligan for. That's like a big advantage. If you know every single card, like what to mulligan for and keep, that's like a big advantage. When to go for the zaps, like when to go for the tempo, when to go for face, when to trade and everything. For sure. Looks like we have a small problem. They're lagging out.
Yeah, apparently there are some technical difficulties on the side of Hyped.
Perhaps concede.
Prep concede.
The chat said that Hype misplayed the last game. He should have prep conceded.
Oh. Yeah, that's definitely the heads up play right there.
Yeah.
Yeah, we might actually see a remake here. Oh, but nothing happened in this game so far, so it's pretty much it doesn't matter.
So both hands looked pretty strong, right? Obviously, both had the backstep, but the player with the coin. Sucks for him to remake, I guess. The coin is a big deal.
Yeah, of course. The coin is definitely a big deal. And it's always 50-50 who gets the coin. But whenever I see I have the coin and I have to remake the game, and I was like, oh, shit, I'm not going to get the coin now. That sucks for me. But it's actually, like, Hype should not believe in that kind of stuff. We will see what happens here. And even without the coin, is it really that much of a difference? Like, does it make that much of a difference actually in terms of statistics?
For me, it's more like when I remake the game and then I have a really bad hand after the remake, then I'm salty. Like, not before. Like, when I remake and then I have like a really, really unplayable hand compared to the hand before, then that sucks. We'll see. So, Maverick has the coin now. Like, that's the coin swap to the other side.
Oh, yeah. And that definitely has to sting a little bit for Hyped here, but we will see what he can make out of this situation. And
Hyped's hand looks much worse.
Did he mulligan already?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, yeah. I think so. Like Maverick mulliganed, but Hyped didn't yet. So we will see what he actually chooses to swap out here.
So the backstep is like a good card. Talos is usually a good card. Like, when I talked to Hyblik earlier, like, it was during next Ramas, because the decks always change, the rogue decks. Talos was, like, a must-keep, always.
Well, Hyblik actually mulliganed everything, and I think he actually got rewarded with the Taurus, and
yeah.
That card can actually come to play in a big way, because often enough, you don't actually play a lot of cards in general in the in this mirror matchup. You usually rack up a lot of cards in your hand early on, and this is where Thorison actually shines.
How important do you think is Thalnos in the mirror?
Thalnos is fine.
Would
I guess
keep it?
Thalnos, along with a backstab, can deal with any kind of 3-drop that Rogue can put out, except for the Shade of Naxxramas, I guess. And that usually is pretty good, considering that Rogue in the mirror matchup always likes to, if he goes aggressive, to just drop those 3-drops on turn 3 and try to apply some pressure with them. So I think it's alright to keep the Blood Mage. Obviously there are better cards that you could get, but I think it's alright to keep it.
For me it's like the most difficult matchup to see who is like ahead. Except it's like very obvious when someone has the full board. Like when you just see the hands, like who would you give the edge here?
Neither of the players has the sprint, so that is obviously a big factor in general. I would actually give the edge to Hyped here because he has this Emperor Thorson.
This is so interesting. Just because of the one card. Like for me, Merrick's hand looks stronger. You know, he has the Shredder into Belch, he has the preparation for whatever he draws. Like, he has the coin. But it's very interesting to see, like, a different...
Yeah, he definitely has a lot of cards to apply pressure. So Maverick might actually be in an okay spot here, but if Hyped is actually able to deal with those cards, and he is right now with the backstab in this SI7, yep. Then Maverick might not be in a good spot, as I thought anyway.
Oh, that's interesting. He coined out the Shredder even though he has 2-5 drops. So he wants to get something on the board as soon as possible.
Yeah, he really wants to apply the pressure early. And often enough, it's really important, like every damage that you can do per turn counts. But Hype being able to deal with this right away with backstab into hero power attack, along with the Vile Teacher generating a pretty decent board here.
It's a pretty weak minion he got out of the Shredder.
But isn't it actually like the average minion you get?
Yeah, it is slightly below average. It's like 2.25 attack and 2... health, something like that. It's like slightly below it.
Yeah, and now Maverick, his coining out the Shredder play made a lot of sense here.
Yeah.
He was actually, maybe he was even anticipating the Violet Teacher here. So, Blood Mage and Eviscerate was pretty decent here.
Hype Sand is kind of bad for dealing with this board. He can't really trigger the Psy to kill the Mad Scientist, except just Deadly Poisoning, but that's kind of weak, you don't want to
Yeah,
do that.
Deadly Poison on one Durability Dagger is not what you want to do, usually. And especially considering you have the Blade Flurry in your hand, you don't really want to waste any weapon buffs that you have.
He could Eviscerate SI, but that also kind of sucks. He really wants to set up the Taurusan for next turn. I'm really like curious to see what he's gonna decide to do. There's like many things you can do.
Yeah, certainly I would say that Hype, considering he played a lot more rogue games than I did for sure.
Or
he
me.
Will come up with a better play than I would actually predict here. Even if we predict the same play. And if I predict a different play, Hype's play is probably better.
Maybe he's just gonna heal bot. Like he's already at He will almost get the full heal. Yeah, he's going for it. It deals with the 2-2, technically.
Yeah, and it saves up your damage potential, the damage output that you have in your hand.
All the combos are still there.
So even if your opponent puts out a lot of minions, you still have all the damage in your hand to deal with them. So I guess this was a fine play.
So do you play Azure Drake? Backstep, that's strong. You don't need to low tap here.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
I think that play is really strong. Oh.
I'm very surprised if he does. He takes the damage. I guess that's fine.
Yeah, taking 3 damage from an antique people doesn't hurt you that much, actually. And low step. It all depends on what kind of hand. Of course, we know that Hyped is just going to drop this Emperor right away.
Yeah.
But often enough, even when your opponent has On this stage of the game, your opponent might just have only spells.
Yeah. The thing is that he, in turn 5, he played the heal bot instead of like an Azure Drake or Sludge Belch or something. It actually shows that he doesn't have a strong 5 drop, right? Which you usually have.
Yeah.
So playing the Lord Tap actually made sense. It looked like he had a lot of spells. But we knew that he had an Emperor.
Are we going to see a prep eviscerate here?
Yeah, it's
to
really
deal with
strong.
His Emperor. Yeah, really good in combination with as a Drake here, I would say. Oh, is he actually considering to zap here?
Zap an Emperor?
I guess it's fine if you consider that eviscerate might also go to face in order to finish the game. We see that Maverick has a lot of pressure on the board, so it might actually be a pretty good play here. But well, I mean, what else are you going to zap in this matchup anyway?
But it might end up costing him the game. We will see like how this play will turn out. If Hype can stabilize. The thing is that Emperor is very slow. You have to replay him. It's very expensive.
Yeah, it's like one of the minions. Probably even the minion that you want to zap, honestly. Every other minion is just cheaper, first of all. And yeah, Eviscerate obviously would have dealt with it permanently. What does Hyped actually get from replaying the Emperor? Pretty much nothing.
He can Emperor here and Eviscerate, but he's deciding to... Will he clear the board somehow? Yeah, he can clear the board with attacking into a minion with Poison and then Blight Fury and then SI.
Looks like that's what Hyped is gonna do.
Maybe he wants to like prep, sprint, and then get replay the Emperor to get like insane amount of value out of it. This guy's toast. Yeah, he's gonna take the Drake. He's taking a lot of damage. But he has the board.
What do you think, Ara? What is the best amount of health to stay at in the mirror matchup?
About 30, man.
About 30?
people, as soon as they have one mod on the board, they can deal like 21 damage at least.
Oh, wow.
It depends on if they play two oils. For me, the Rook is the hardest list to figure out during the game. Like to go card by card. In the other matchups, as soon as I see one card, you can really like predict 25 cards at least. If you play against a Druid, Fast Druid or something like that, if you play against Boria, if you play against Face Hunter, like it doesn't matter, really know very quickly the list, but Rogue is very difficult. People take so many different cards.
Yeah, you can pretty much, I agree with that actually. It's really hard actually to predict. Probably Rogue is the hardest class to predict how much damage you can take in one turn, because it varies so much from game to game.
Yeah, and just if someone plays one oil or two oils, it's so... Such a big difference in damage output, and but when I watch like Mr. Yagut or something, for them they know exactly the list as soon as it's like you really see the experience from a experienced Rogue player.
Yeah, that is the benefit of playing this class a lot. You just know it inside out, and this is also why I thought that Hype has the advantage here.
Oh, that's a sick the zap draw. Pretty sick tempo, but the Taurus, like the, it's not that crazy, you know, this turn, because he had the preparation hand. Sprint is 1 mana cheaper, but the Viscerate was already 1 mana, so it's not that crazy this turn.
Now we see Maverick drawing his Taurus.
Is he gonna zap his Emperor? Oh my god,
second time the zap on the Emperor. Oh my god, this is the
this is actually very funny.
Yeah, it actually is. But he really values that Eviscerate to the face. Oh, this is a lot of burst.
In one game, I actually saw that preparation gets minus mana. I wonder how it works. I want to see that.
Like it actually does work like that, because if you play a low tap, then preparation would actually cost 4.
Yeah.
So that is sometimes this is actually an interaction which is relevant.
Yeah, I agree. So he's just going for the Emperor again.
Yeah, Hype being at 15 health really has to be careful with this, with the amount of burst that he can take. Yeah. And Maverick pretty much only really relying on drawing that Tinker's Traps at all in this situation.
But as soon as he gets it, like his hand is super cheap, like he could play everything.
Yeah, the Tinker's Traps at all, would it actually threaten lethal? It's like 2 from the deckhand, plus 1 from the hero power, that's 3, and 6 from Tinker's Traps at all, that's 9. Plus 6, that's actually 15, that's lethal.
Wow, that's crazy.
I think his Traps at all would be lethal here.
And he had the Sludge Belcher, like if it would draw something else, like he could really do so much damage. But oil would kill him. So he got the worst draw, obviously, that's what you don't want to prepare top deck when you're like behind in draws as a rogue.
Yeah, unfortunately now for Maverick, considering he didn't get that Tinker's Traps at all game that he really wanted to get, he might actually have to finally use the Eviscerate on the Emperor.
So, is he gonna play also the...
Oh, is he just gonna go face with this? Wow.
He has the...
That is unexpected, the but balls. Definitely...
Because Tinkers is, again, lethal.
Yeah, it's a play to win.
Yeah.
Do you keep the Southsea Deccan in hand, though? I guess if you expect Southsea Deccan to be handled anyway, you might as well keep it in your hand.
Wait, if you just attack now, do you still win with Tinkers? No. Then you're one off. Kinda need the... You need the deckhand for all.
Yeah, if you keep the deckhand, Tinker's Sharp Throw still represents lethal.
But now you would be one off. Like if Hype can deal with this and he draws the oil, he would be very sad.
We'll definitely see a prep sprint and sprint costing two mana.
Yeah.
2 mana.
That's pretty good.
2 mana and 8 mana remaining. You know, that is the power of Thorison right there. 8 mana with 4 fresh cards in hand, 5 cards in hand, 4 hyped right away. What does he get here? Oh, that's actually nothing to clear the board properly here. I guess he has Azure Drake into Eviscerate for the Sludge Belcher here. That's pretty decent.
But he even has to kill the slime here.
Oh, the Zap might actually be really decent.
Oh man, he will Zap for sure. Because he has to push for damage as well.
Yeah, the Zap and then the Southsea Deckhand can get handled by the SI7. 5 damage going to the face with the Emperor.
It's a really big deal that he draw the Zap. So he has lethal next turn for sure.
Yeah, and this is where playing the Southsea Deckhand actually might have backfired, considering that Maverick might just draw into the Sharp Throw right now.
If he draws it now, oh my god, he will be. I think that will affect his next game. If you knew that you would have won if you wouldn't have played it, but let's see what he draws.
Man, this series has been so close.
Yeah.
It's amazing. Maverick was really... Like, the whole theme of the game was Maverick valuing his Eviscerate so much to actually finish off the game quickly.
Yeah.
And this actually...
Oh my god!
He got it!
Oh my god! Oh. That is so unfortunate. Well, oh my god, it is lethal.
Oh, it is lethal.
We are so bad.
Oh, you said it's one off!
Yeah,
what the hell?
I thought it was one off.
Okay, never mind. I didn't see it either. Well, we're both stupid, apparently.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
Okay, so you just won the game. Oh my god, that was a real top deck, right?
Yeah, well played. But in that case, it didn't matter at all with the Southsea Deckhand. Okay. Never mind. Maverick played well. We will not doubt his play skill for sure. I mean, we know that Maverick is a very good player.
Yeah.
And we shouldn't judge him any other way. So Maverick once again taking the lead in what was sort of unexpected, I think, at least for me. I thought Hyped would definitely have the advantage, and even though he was on the back foot a lot of the time, he was facing a lot of pressure from Maverick. He actually came back into the game pretty well with a lot of Emperor Taurus activations, but in the end, Maverick drawing the cards he needed, and right now we're gonna get right into the game. Maverick down to this last deck. And it's going to be the Druid versus Hyped's Rogue.
That was actually crazy. I can't believe that the last top deck. Like when your opponent has like full board, full hand, right? And then you need one card. It's like playing face hunt a little bit, but it's more unlikely. And then he just got the right card. I think he even played two Eviscerates, so that was like the only card he could draw.
Oh, actually, Hyped chose to keep the Lothar. What do you think of that?
Oh, that's very interesting. But I think you would keep every 5-drop except the Healbot. You really want the minions. He said like you want any minion till turn 5. Like, yeah. Like any
minion, like I thought Hyde would go for a little bit of more aggressive route, hoping to get a little more cheaper minions, maybe. But I guess
the thing how he says Mulligan is it really depends what the other cards are. Like if you have a backstep or like a combination of cards, he usually keeps a combination of cards.
Okay. Yeah, we're definitely going to see the Fan of Knives, considering he has two of them. He might as well use one for cycling. Gets an Azodrake, so he has a pretty decent play lined up for the following turns. Turn 4 coin into 5 drop into another 5 drop.
Coin
that's
is
pretty decent.
Yeah, coin is definitely what he wanted as well.
Alright, but now facing down the Shredder, what does Hype do?
Yeah, and he has the Lord tap too. And he has the Harrison. Like, the Druid has exactly the two cards you want in this matchup.
Yeah, those are the most important cards to have in this matchup, that's for sure. The Harrison obviously being able to deal with any sort of buffed weapon that Rogue might leave behind. And Lothab obviously potentially even giving an extra turn, often enough.
So he's going for his Lothab. But the Druid really doesn't care about this Lothab. Just play your own Lothab.
Yeah, in this stage of the game, Druid usually doesn't care about Lothabs that much. Lothabs generally disrupt the Druid a lot better in the late game, where Druid tries to finish off your opponent with the combo.
I think the Druid has a really big edge here. He has already the Force of Nature Savage Roar, and he is pressuring the Rogue from the start. And the Rogue is forced to trade.
Yeah, and especially with minions, with charged minions like Druid of the Claw and the Swipe as well, representing extra damage, Hype might actually get into the combo range very early.
Yeah, he has also the Harrison if he poisons. Because he might poison next turn, because he will probably swipe this. Would you swipe this? Check the card you want to swipe, the Drake. And push for more damage.
He could do that. He could also just trade his Pile the Treader into it. Or just ignore it if he's not afraid of AoE.
Oh man. And then the Hype will probably poison it down. And then he will Harrison. It doesn't really look good for Hype at all.
Yeah, we'll have to see how afraid Maverick is of what the potential of Hype's hand might be, because that is going to impact his decision in this turn for sure. There are definitely a lot of options that Maverick can take. And he chooses to trade. He is afraid of the spell damage and the minion. Yeah, the option of just going face with that and threaten an earlier kill. Oh, the Innervate makes Shade of Nexstorm as possible.
Or combo next turn.
Or a combo next turn, that's true. But now, considering that he played the Shade, this opens up. This opens him up for a big Blade Flurry.
Yep.
But Hype does not have it right now. He has the Blood Mage into Fan of Knives, though, so that's going to clear a Shade at least.
Does he have a backstep? Yeah, he has a backstep.
And the backstep, we'll be able to clear the Azurdrake. And the Hero Power will be able to clear the leftover Bloodsail Raider.
Oh, preparation is also good. So, he got a couple good draws. So, yeah. We were really like it. The Harrison will be like the deciding play. Depends on how well Hype will play around it. Will he even play around it?
Yeah, but look at this. Look at this Druid of the Claw.
Oh my god.
And the swipe on the next turn will put him down to 14.
But Hype has a heal bot, so we will see if he's going to be able to.
Yeah.
The heal bot might actually be very, very huge.
Yeah, the heal bot will definitely play a very important role. This is what you need to stay out of range of the combo. Because have we seen Hype actually play any Belchers or Taunters like that? No, right? He just plays Healbot instead.
Also no Fuzziers.
Yeah, so no heal for hyped, at least from what we have seen. So this healbot will definitely play an important role in this matchup for sure.
So yeah, he's going for swipe, innovate, sludge belcher, and trying to finish him next turn.
Yeah, that will set up for the combo. And hype does have plenty of solutions to play around that. He could zap the belcher, which is pretty good tempo play always.
With the would you go with the, like, if you zap it, you can as well go with the Valor Teacher. 17 life is.
Oh, he's going for a big Edwin.
Oh yeah, that's pretty good. Is he going for 6-6? He's thinking right now if he should just play a 6-6.
Yeah, it looks like he's going for that. Feeling the threat of the potential big game hunter. He doesn't want to get blown out by that.
I think if you play many games, that's like the most consistent, like Van Cleef to go for against Druid, to go for the 6-6, not bigger.
In general, I would say. Because a lot of decks just run big game hunter and usually you don't need more than 6 health anyway. Well, 6 health is so much.
So he can clear the 3-3 and play the slash, but you have to do it. There's no other play. Just combo ring, no way. You can clear with combo, but that's like, that's all awful. You can't do that. So you guys just. So like Hyped has the two poisons, but he wasn't forced to play them yet. So the Harrison is just sitting in the. Oh, he's not playing ref. He's not playing the ref. Is that greedy? Do you need? You needed to kill the 6-6, right? But it's weird, right? When you have the opportunity to kill a 3-3, what would you have done? Would you do the same?
It is hard to say. You also might sometimes need the Wrath to maybe draw into something. Wrath definitely one of the cards that for Druid that offers a lot of versatility. You can definitely save it up so often enough to see what, like, just for the moment where you actually need it. And then you can choose the specific mode that you want. But yeah, clearing one of the healbot would have definitely been pretty decent, I would say.
Oh my god.
Now the sap, once again.
Insane tempo. That's like the card you want to have against Druid, like zap with something on board.
Yeah, and Hyped already having used both of the saps, definitely in a commanding position right now. Dealing a lot of damage and pressuring the Druid.
Oh, is he going to attack with the dagger? Probably not, right? He's just setting it up. Oh, he is. He's also playing around Harrison. So now Harrison is just too weak.
Yeah. We might still see it, though.
Yeah. Is he going for the Sludge Purge now? Sludge Purge is effectively, like, more...
It's just buying some time, but it doesn't deal with the board properly. And the Tinker Sharps are along
draw.
With the Blade Flurry and the Deadly Poison. It's going to clear the board.
Is that lethal?
Wow, this is a lot of damage coming in. Oh my god.
It might be lethal. Like, it's too... It depends probably where the Tinker hits. Like, what minion. If you hit the one guy that was just spawned, or the other guy that was...
The chance is high that it will hit a minion that can attack, but it doesn't.
Is that still lethal though?
So Blade Fury dealing 6 damage to the face.
That's
and combined
damage.
With the 10, 11, 14.
It is lethal. Is it? Yeah. It is lethal.
That is exact lethal right there. Wow. And Hype tying up the series, the Rogue Master himself trying to make a comeback here. Was 2-1 behind and now tying it up once again. And this, both players down to their last deck, Maverick on his Druid that he just lost with, and Hyped.
They're just going. Are we already in the next game?
Yeah, we are, but we have to leave because we don't see Hyped's hand. So, Hyped down to his Hunter. No, wait, what? Hunter or Mage?
Mage.
Mage, yeah.
He won with the Hunter against the Warrior. It looked, looked very good for the Druid. Like, he had the Lord Tap and the Harrison, right? But there was no opportunity for a good Harrison.
So, sorry about that. We missed the mulligans, but we definitely didn't miss anything of the opening action right there.
Oh, another good matchup for Hyped. The Mech Mage versus the Druid.
So yeah, this is definitely what Maverick did not want to see. He really needed that win against the Rogue with his Druid, because we all know that Mechmage is heavily favored against the Druid most of the time, especially considering that Mirror Entity is so devastating against Druid often enough.
We missed if he kept on Mirror Entity, because this is like looks like a bad tent. Like what I heard, some people just keep the Mirror Entity.
It definitely, in most scenarios, it's just terrible to have those Mirror Entities, because considering you can get them from Mad Scientist, it's just much more value that way. However, against Druid, this might be actually one of the matchups where Mirror Entity, keeping Mirror Entity is fine.
Yep. He has the Wild Growth, which is obviously nice.
Considering that Druid pretty much just doesn't run any minions that cost less than 3, except for maybe one Zombie Chow, Mirror Entity will always generate some sort of value.
He's going for the Keeper.
Yeah, the Keeper is one of those minions that you are kind of happy to give your opponent with the Mirror Entity here. Considering that the opponent doesn't get the Battlecry and it's just the same amount of stats that you would get for a 3 drop anyway, usually.
Oh, Toshli as well. Do you Blast Mage here?
I guess it's fine, but I would... I would probably attack first. And you might increase the... Then you might improve the odds that you actually hit... the minion
so
twice.
Attack with the Keeper into Keeper and then Blast Mage.
Yeah, that's what I would do. The Blast Mages are so devastating. It's just such a beefy minion that deals so much damage when coming into play. And he gets the perfect hits.
Perfect hits. As you said, first attack. Got the perfect hits as well. Swipe is... He had already one swipe. Swipe coin shade. Or Hero Power. You really want to get the Shade out. Like, when you have it in your hand, the longer you wait, the worse the card will be.
Yeah, that's true, and Maverick definitely sees this, needs the Shade as early as... Like, cutting it out right now is definitely important in order for the Shade to grow big enough to actually trade 2-for-1 for enemy minions.
And now the Nightmare of Lore. That card will trade perfectly with the Lore.
Yeah, Toshli... One of those cards that we've seen Tempo Storm members bring here to this tournament, unlike other players. Other players kind of ridicule this card for being a Boulderfist Ogre with lesser stats, but Boulderfist Ogre often enough can deal a lot of damage.
Yeah.
But considering it has 7 health, it's so hard to deal with.
The main reason for why we play this card is because of the Emperor. Every deck plays it, and it's like a 6-drop that contests the 6-drop.
Yeah, that's absolutely true.
So he's just going for the clear. It's pretty good clear, but obviously... Like, it's a clear, but he's fighting from behind.
Yeah, what sucks for Maverick here is that he has the... He does have the combo, but obviously nothing to back it up. There's no board presence at all for Maverick. So this combo is most likely going to be used to clear the board that the Mechmage will definitely establish here.
Do you think you would play the Mirror Entity? Like, he saw the Shade and the Keeper. Yeah, he's going for it.
Yeah, a lot of minions have been played that are kind of small. And
he's thinking
it's very likely that Maverick will just have to be forced to play big minions now.
Yeah.
And the Mirror Entity definitely cripples the turns for Maverick right now.
Oh, that's like that Mirror Entity. Like,
yeah, you just have to give him the 5-5. A 3-mana 5-5, that's like King Mukla value right there.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
That sucks.
It's not what Maverick wanted to see, obviously, but considering that he's still at 21 health, he might be in a fairly secure position still. Obviously, hype with the advantage still.
If you could get an Innovate and have like some double Savage Roar combo, he might have. But that looks right now. It looks like really bad. He will just probably Frostbolt 5-5 and go for face.
There's also the option of maybe, I don't know, taunting up something with the Rusty Horn. Like taunting up the Harvest Golem to stop the attack from the Ancient of Lore on the other Ancient of Lore.
Then you might as well buff it with the attack. And he has the stealth as well, if he draws Tantonidas. So right now...
There's even like some fun possibilities with Time Rewinder on the Ancient of Lore to draw two cards.
Are you always like perfectly keeping track of how many spare parts your opponent has? Because like for Mary it looks like he hyped as a full hand, but it's like four spare parts.
Yeah, I mean he has to know, yeah. I think. I choose to go for the taunt on the Harvest Golem as expected. Dealing a lot of damage with his Ancient of Lore to the face. He's threatening a lot of damage next turn. Maverick, though, does have the option of clearing a lot of the stuff.
You have to
combo. With Force of Nature combo.
Like, there's no other way.
Of course, he has to do it.
If you don't do it, you're dead.
And that will pretty much clear everything, except for the damaged golem that is popping out of the Harvest Golem. But on the other hand, though, Maverick loses his whole board and gives Hype once again the initiative to...
He's clearing everything.
Okay. Yeah, he has to.
I mean, he clears also the damage golem. It's like a perfect...
Oh yeah, you're right. I forgot the hero attack, sorry.
But he's so low on life. But yeah. Hyped is out of cards, so actually...
Yeah, look at this. It's just a bunch of spare parts and Frostbolt. Yeah. That's nothing.
So, it doesn't look so bad. He has the Druid of the Claw for taunt. You have to taunt. You can't give your opponent like any... So this looks actually very good for Merrick.
I will see most likely Azodrake into Druid of Claw in taunt mode, I would say.
That's also a very good important draw. Like he will probably heal.
He will need it to heal up. He is way ahead in cards. So yeah. All that Maverick is afraid of right now is that potential burst from fireballs.
And that is a dead draw for Hyped, like the blast mage with no
max.
So he can't buff the Cogmaster.
Yeah, Scientist generating no value because, as we know, both Mirror Entities are gone already. However, that finicky cloak field on the Blast Mage might actually threaten a lot of damage, considering that Maverick doesn't have any taunts.
Or heals, but we know he's gonna heal up this turn.
Yeah, he just has to. But the heal will just kind of be negated by the attack from the Blast Mage next turn.
So it really depends what type will top deck their next turns.
Yeah, he needs a series of good draws, though. Like one card is not enough.
Yeah, he needs a couple fireballs, Antonidas.
Maverick on the verge of stabilizing. Can Hyped draw into the lethal? Pilot Treader. It's kind of an alright draw, considering you can also get some pretty bad minions like one drops or two drops. So it's not the best, not the worst though.
He's going for the...
Oh, the Time Rewinder on the Blast Mage.
Oh man, if it hits the Zundrake, that would be like really, really sick. Oh my god!
So close!
Oh my god!
So close too! Yeah, I guess that's the play the type that had to do there in order to like... Just get the unfair advantage.
Yeah. If he would have... Yeah. But now if he draws the Zwidrake, that would be... Like, I mean, the Antonidas. Sometimes you have to do the risky...
What is actually more likely? That you kill the Azodrake with the Blast Mage or that you draw the Antonidas on the following turn? What are the percentages on that? Kara, come on. You're good in math, right?
I think I would wait for the Antonidas. Like, I mean, hitting the Zundrake three times, come on. That's like... I guess you can go for it, I don't know. If you get it, it's like a winning play.
Yeah, I guess so. And now speaking of game-winning plays, Maverick looking to close out the series with his Dr. Boom.
You have to trade, there's no way he's gonna go face here. He's calculating lethal for next turn if he ignores it, because Hyped is out of cards, right? He knows he has to top deck.
Yeah, of course, but Fireball would spell disaster here.
No, he would be one off.
No, but
no, it's exact lethal. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Oh my god, if he top decks Fireball, oh my god, that's very, very...
doesn't get it.
Wow,
that was really risky from Maverick here, I think.
That's unnecessary risk, right?
I think so too.
Like, you're really in a domain. He has also the Lore Tavern and stuff. Like, he can always clear the board every turn.
I guess he just really wanted to make a push for lethal right away with the Savage Roar. Considering that Hyped goes for the attack to the face here. That was a really ballsy play by Maverick right there. But he sets up for lethal next turn with the Savage Roar by taking face.
He just had to dodge two bullets. It's like two fireballs left, right? Wait, but Hype plays fireballs. I don't even know. Like, some make mages cut the frostbolt, some make mages cut the fireballs.
So we see right there, Maverick. This is enough to damage, right?
Yeah, of course
it is. Maverick with a Savage Roar and a lot of minions closing out the series. 3-2-2.
Very close.
And very close contested, especially in that Rogue Mirror matchup that we saw. A lot of great games for sure, and obviously Hype not out of it yet. He will be facing, he will be facing Firebat in the losers match. But before we get to that,
well, Firebat lost to Oscar Kai. I didn't even know.
Yeah. It's gonna be at the same time.
Yeah.
So which game will be on stream? So the winner match, Oskaka versus Maverick. That Sick. Is going to be huge. Two of those players, like, highly underrated by many, by obviously the wide public, but amongst the pros, very well-regarded professional players that can perform at the highest level, for sure. Oskaka looking to make his breakthrough performance, as well as Maverick, because despite winning the tournament of Gamers Origin, that wasn't like widely regarded to be like one of the high caliber tournaments, and definitely looking to make his mark here as well. I personally picked Oskaka as one of the favorites to win this. I actually picked him as my pick to win this tournament. If I don't make it.
Yeah, a lot of actually talked to a lot of pros. Many saw this group actually as one of the two groups of death. This group, like, because pros don't underestimate Maverick and Oskaka as one of the, like, top players.
Yeah.
And as we can see, Hyped and Firebat are in the losers bracket, probably not expected by many viewers.
Yeah, this is kind of a recurring theme, honestly, though. We see a lot of underrated players, especially the ones who made it through the qualifiers, like Oskaka.
Ignite.
Ignite as well. We've seen a lot of players in recent tournaments as well, like the Viagame House Cup and IEM Katowice, where qualified players just make their mark and win those whole things by punching their ways, punching their tickets in through the qualifiers, making their way to the main event, winning the whole thing, and making the name for themselves. This is pretty much the Hearthstone dream for the everyman player, right?
I think that a lot of viewers, like, watching this, they're like really getting pumped and thinking like, yeah, I'm gonna be the next Huey or Orange or maybe Oskaka or Ignite.
Yeah, of course. I mean, anyone can pretty much do it, as you know. And all you have to do is keep practicing, keep trying, and maybe you're on your way to the next tournament victory. But we'll see. There's still a lot of big names in this tournament that those qualified players have to go through. But we will see right now what is going to happen. Like, after this, it's going to be Oskaka versus Maverick, the winner's match, to see who advances to the top 8. Don't go anywhere, guys. We'll see you right there.